Shopify got a new code editor. And you guys are happy?
Sad? Angry?
I know some of you guys are because especially my visitors of the channel, merchant of the Shopify stores, not actually the developer. I mean, it is easy for me to use that editor because I've been using VS Code for a lot of time. And that new code editor is very much alike VS Code. But merchants were used to using the old interface where you guys got really hang of it. I mean, you were very easily using that. But now the new theme code editor is here and everyone is frustrated that how to use it, how to find the files, it's glitchy. It is not glitchy. It is a little different to use, which I am going to cover in this video and show you guys how you can use the new Shopify code editor. So if you are a Shopify store owner, merchant, and not tech savvy, this is a basic beginner level tutorial which will teach you how to use the latest Shopify code editor. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. Before we do that, make sure to subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments below. I have created a lot of videos related to Shopify about free sections and about how you can improve the layout of your Shopify store. I have basically created like 150 plus sections completely for free in this channel, which you can download and use on your Shopify store completely for free and improve the layout of your store. So make sure to subscribe the channel. Now let's get into the screen. Okay guys, so that's the latest code editor of Shopify. And first of all, let's take a look at the code editor settings from this gear icon. So when you click on that, you have this themes option where we can change the color palette. So here we have themes under color theme. We can change the color to solarized light, or we can change it to anything we want. Not anything we want, whatever is available here, right? And I personally like this one. Not personally, I mean, most of the developers like this one because it is very similar to the Visual Studio code. So that is the file explorer and that is the code editor. If I open up the code editor, my Visual Studio code, you will see that it is quite similar to that. That is why developers are happy, but merchants, store owners are not happy. So that is how the VS Code editor looks like. You can see that it has this explorer similar to Shopify, and code editing also works really similar. You can also see that here we have this gear icon to change the different things. We also have this themes within the VS Code editor. Also, the shortcuts are very much similar to the Shopify code editor, right? So that how developers are happy, but merchants or store owners are not happy because it looks tech savvy. It looks overwhelming because previous code editor had fewer functionalities, but this one have a lot. Now we changed the theme. Now, if you want to search for any files, you would go to Command P. That is how you search the file. Command P in case you're using Mac, or Control P if you are using Windows. I'm going to hit Command P and then search for any file which I want to, like theme.liquid, right? Like style or base.css, where you would want to add CSS of your store, right? So that's how you find the file. And now let's see how you can find the code if you want to. Now here we have this search icon. If you click on that, you will be able to search all of the files and the code which you will type here. So let's suppose I am searching for copyright. Now it is going to search the word copyright in all of the files. In previous code editor, if we wanted to search a code snippet in all of the files, we would have to download the theme, extract the theme, open in VS Code, and then search the text within the files, all of the files, just like we are doing it right here, right now. That's why VS Code was very handy. But Shopify code editor has all of this functionality now. Now, if you want to search anything within all the files, you can simply click on search icon and then search for that specific text. And if you want to replace everything in all of the files, you can do that by simply searching that and clicking on this replace, adding the text, and then simply replace all. It will appear and it will replace all of the stuff, right? Now let's open up the file, any of the file. Here is our theme. I am using Horizon theme. That is the theme which I'm using. Currently it is 2.1.1. I just click on these three small dots and then click on edit code in order to open this code editor. Now let's search within the file. Let's say you don't want to find code in all of the files. You just want to file it in one single file. So I would just, let's open up assets and find for a CSS file or JS file, wherever you want to make any change. Let's suppose this accordion custom.js is the file where you want to search the code. You would open this file, press Command F if you're on a Mac and Control F if you are on Windows, and search for any of the code. Right? And you can replace as well if you want to, and you can replace everything within that file at once if you want to, right? So that's how to search within the file, and we learned how to search the file, right? And now let's create a new file. Let's say you are creating a new section file. I have created a lot of sections in this channel. Again, make sure to subscribe to the channel and get free sections, which I have created just for you guys. If you want to add slider, if you want to add FAQ section, if you want to add before after section, a lot of sections which I have created completely for free in my YouTube channel. So if you go to YouTube, WebSense Pro, and go to playlists, I have sections playlist where it is. So this is for the color swatches, this is for the transparent header for the Dawn theme, and here we have the section playlist. So if I click on view full playlist, these are all of the sections which you can find completely for free. FAQ section, free shipping upsell, video with autoplay, transparent header, sticky add to cart, and a lot of different sections which you can find. Right now, in order to add those sections which I have created for you guys, you would just click on this sections folder and then click on this plus sign and name your section whatever you want to name, and name the file new section.liquid, and we have our section file created under sections folder. Now you would simply paste the code which I have provided in all of my tutorials and then save. It also automatically auto save for you. So in case you mistakenly close the tab, it will be automatically saved. So if I click on this gear icon here and then click on settings, which is the settings for this code editor, we have the option of this save. So if you want to auto save after delay, on focus change, on window change, an editor which changes automatically saved when window loses focus, these are all of the settings for auto save. If you want to change the font of the code, if you want to change the size, I mean, there are a lot of functionalities available now with this code editor. Again, it's a little more confusing for the store owners and merchants, but it's very handy for the code editors. So this was a basic level tutorial on how to search for the file, how to search for the code within all of the files, how to create a new file, just like I did. You can also press Command N in order to create a new file, just like VS Code Editor. Or you can also open up these options where you can create new file, new folder, download, upload the file directly to this folder, and all of that stuff, right? Now, once you have made the changes in the code editor and saved it, now you would want to preview it. In order to preview the theme, you would click on this Shopify icon, right? And then click on preview store. Previously, we had three small dots where we had Shopify preview option showing up, but now it is in this Shopify icon. Click on that and then click on preview store. And this is for the theme customizer, if you want to open up the theme customizer. So I'm gonna open the theme customizer. If I want to add new sections, new template, or anything like that, right? So here is my theme customizer. Now, in order to create a new template, what you can do here is go to templates and then create a new file, .json if you want to create a JSON template, or .liquid if you want to create a .liquid template. Simply click on this plus icon or open the options and then create a new file, right, for the templates. You can also create a new template by theme customizer. So if I want to create a new product page template, I'm simply gonna go to products from this dropdown and then click on create template. So these are the two ways you can create new template in Shopify with a new code editor. If you want to, the theme customizer option were already there. It's the old method, but you can still use code editor in order to create a new template. Now let's try to add a new section in our Horizon theme. So I'm gonna open up this folder here, click on this icon or click on new file here. I'm gonna name it testimonial section.liquid. So that's my new file, testimonial section.liquid, and I'm gonna use the code from one of my video to add the testimonial. So that's the testimonial section, which I have added on my channel. Oops.
Hi guys. Okay, let's go. Okay.
So that is the simple testimonial section, and that is the code for that. So here is the code. I am going to copy the code present in the blog, click on copy code, and then paste the code and hit save. Perfect. Now, in order to test the section which we added, we are customized. You can see that we are on the homepage. I'm going to hit refresh in our theme customizer. And then click on art section and search for testimonial. You can see that we have our section added. So that's how we can add our section. So let's add the section. Here's how easy it is to add the section. Just create the file and paste the code. Now you can also compare the file and see the timeline, meaning if I remove this code and press Command S or hit save, you can see that this is the version created, file saved. So it is having like the complete timeline of the code changes. So I just removed another code, remove that, click on save. You can see that it's now saving everything in the timeline, and we can simply revert it back from the timeline. So I just need to revert this version here. So I'm gonna click and then click on restore contents. And here you go. You can see that all of the code is back, right? Now, if I hit save, it is going to also tell you that we did this workplace edit, right? All of the history is saved. So this is the comparison of the changes which we made in version 6 from version 5. The version 5 had this code, or version 5 had this code, and in version 6 we got it back, right? So that's how you can use the timeline, and you can also compare the files. So let me show you how to compare the files. Let's create a duplicate of this file. If I have the duplicate file created, I'm going to remove some of the code from this file, which is this here. Now let's save. And now let's compare it with this file. So click on select for compare, and then compare with selected. Now you can see the difference between two files. On our left side, we have testimonial section copy.liquid, and on our right side, we have testimonial.section.liquid, where we can easily see the comparison of these two files, right? So I think that's it for this video. I don't want to make this video too long. There are a ton of functionalities which have been released in shape in terms of this VS Code editor within the Shopify. So let me know in the comments below if you still have any confusion. And until next video, have a great day.